Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. In this video, we're continuing to look at common tools that appear in different photo editors. This time, it's the turn of the blending modes. In the last video of the series, I explained about the advantages of using layers. If you haven't seen it, I'll include a link in the video details below. One of the advantages I mentioned was that you can use blending modes with layers. In this video, I'll explain a few of these blending modes and how you can use them. If you watched the layers video, you may recall that we can build up the editing of an image using multiple layers. We also said that each of these layers has a blending mode, which you can see in the layers window. The blending mode controls how a layer reacts with the other layers below it in the layer stack. The default blending mode is called normal, but there are lots of other blending modes that you can select. One of the easiest blending modes to understand is multiply. We can see how this works using our simple gradient strip. We've looked at this strip in previous videos where we said there were two systems to represent tones of black through to white. In tools like Photoshop, black has a value of 0 and white of 255. In Affinity Photo, you see another system where black is 0% and white is 100%. Another way of writing these percentages is as a decimal number. Here, 0% is just 0, and 100% is 1. Our mid-tone grey with a value of 50% can also be written as 0.5. When we set the blending mode of a layer, it controls how the layer blends with the layers below it to produce an effect. Here, I've got the original gradient strip. And I've got a second copy of the tone strip where the blending mode is set to normal. Watch what happens to this mid-tone grey when I set the blending mode to multiply. You could see that it causes a strip to become darker. That's because mid-tone grey has a value of 0.5, and when I set the blending mode to multiply, it multiplies the tone value for that with the layer below it. If you multiply 0.5 with 0.5, you get a new tonal value of 0.25. This is a much darker grey and sits midway between 0 and 0.5 on the tone strip. By using the multiply blending mode, we can make tones in our image darker. Let's have a quick look at how we might use a blending mode like multiply. One way is to create a copy of your image and then set the blending mode to multiply. You can then use masks and an opacity setting to control where and how intense this darkening effect is. Another simple technique is to add a new adjustment layer, like a curves adjustment layer. Without making any changes to the curve, you can then set the blending mode to see the same effect on the image. Again, it's possible to change the opacity and use masks to control the effect. So far, we've looked at the multiply blending mode, but there are others we can use. The opposite of multiply is screen. This will lighten the image tones and can be a good way to brighten shadow areas. Here you can see the effect of using screen causes all the image to become lighter and some areas have actually become pure white. You can of course control this with a mask, the opacity settings or something called the blend if control, which I'll cover in a future video. As well as multiply and screen, there are two other blending modes that are particularly useful for photo editing. These are contrast enhancing blending modes, which cause an increase in the contrast of your image. They are the overlay and soft light. The results are similar, but soft light causes less areas to become pure white and blow out. These blending modes work by making the dark image tones darker and the light image tones lighter. They determine if an image tone is dark or light by comparing it against a mid-tone grey. If a pixel in the image is a mid-tone grey, then setting the blending mode to either overlay or soft light won't have any effect. You can see this using a layer that's filled with mid-tone grey. When the layer's blending mode is set to normal, the mid-tone grey of the layer hides the image. If I set the blending mode to multiply, then it darkens the image. If I set the blending mode to screen, the image becomes lighter. When I set the blending mode to overlay, the grey layer vanishes and it doesn't have any effect. That's because mid-tone grey has no effect when it's blended with overlay or soft light. Now let's look at Affinity Photo. As in Photoshop, you can see the mid-tone layer is visible when it has the blending mode set to normal. Set the blending mode to multiply and it darkens the image. Setting it to screen lightens the image, just as we saw before. And again, if we set the blending mode to overlay or soft light, the mid-tone grey layer just vanishes. Blending modes appear in lots of different photo editors, and they all work in the same way. We've covered four of the blending modes in this video, or five if you want to include the normal mode. Once you understand and can use blending modes in an editor, you can easily transfer this knowledge to another. In a future video, I'm going to look at the blend if controls in Photoshop, and I also explain how they work in Affinity Photo, because it's slightly different and much more powerful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.